What's good, TMG fam? It's your boy L, and I'm back with another reaction, man. How y'all feel? Welcome back to the channel. Listen, man, I hope y'all ain't got nothing else planned to do this today, tomorrow. I mean, he got 20 songs on the album, bro. 20 songs on the album, man. I hope you don't have nothing else to do, because I just wiped my plans clear. Like, I ain't even gonna see my kids and my old lady today, man. It's not happening. I don't have time for them now. Nah, I'm just joking, but listen, man, the next joint we're going to get into is Premonition. This is the intro to the album, Music to be Murdered By. Let's get into the title, bro. Music to be Murdered By. Like, that's so strong to me, man. That's so strong, especially with, you know what I'm saying, all the backlash and all the different things he's heard or received or dealt with. And you know what I mean? So the title alone just strikes me as just, he put a lot of, and of course, it's Eminem. He definitely put a lot of thought into it. You know what I'm saying? But it's just a tough title. Look, man, I can't stop doing that since he did that in the interview. When they asked him a question about Joe Budden, he was like, I had to do that. You know what I'm saying? So let's get into this joint right here, man, and check it out. See what it's about. Here we go. And man, rest in peace for all the rappers who think they can rap fast. Because Godzilla, oh my God. If y'all ain't seen Godzilla, go check out my last reaction. Listen to it first. Give him his streams. Then go check out my last reaction, bro. Oh my God. Premonition. Here we go. This dude, man. He always burying somebody. And that alone in itself is a metaphor, bro. He always burying somebody. So that should let us know right there. Somebody on this album is gonna get buried. Somebody on this album is getting buried, man.
Yeah. So I guess this is what it is, huh? I think it's obvious. We ain't never gonna see eye to eye. But it's funny. As much as I hate you, I need you.
This is music.
That line right there, he could be addressing anybody. You know what I'm saying? The fans, the critics, as much as I hate you, I need you. You know what I'm saying? The critics, as much damage as they try to do, they also still bring awareness and attention. If you still believe in the saying of, you know what I'm saying, bad publicity is good as, is just as good as good publicity. You know what I'm saying? So as much as I hate you, I need you. Y'all still gonna keep my name alive. You know what I mean? Like, even when I'm not putting music out, y'all still gonna keep my name alive.
To be murdered.
First off, who produced this? I don't have it on here, so I'm gonna have to look after I'm done, bro. But who, that track is fire, bro. The beats is fire. The beat is fire. And I told, he does not forget. He don't forget, man. He like an NFL player that got dropped from the first round to the sixth round. And he kept a chip on his shoulder. He like Tom Brady, who kept that chip on his shoulder throughout his entire career for doing that to him. He never forgets, bro. Never forgets. So with all the backlash from the albums and different things like that, that's why we got what we got on Godzilla. That's why we gonna continue to get stuff like that, bro. He got that chip.
Why would I get a chip on my shoulder? I was considered one time as the dinner. These hypocrites are trying to get rid of. But why would I get a chip on my shoulder? I was considered one time as the illest. Bitch, I'm still as fly as the zipper. True, I just get richer. But if it was ever all about Skrilla, then I would have quit her long motherfucking time ago. Bitch, shut the fuck up, I should go say that shit to Tech Nine or the Jigga. Nobody says shit about 2 Chainz as long as he's been here. Shit, no wonder you're mad now. I'm looking at them plaques, count them. I'm LL Cool J, bigger and deafer. I sell like 4 mil when I put out a bad album. Revival flop came
Exactly. Talk your shit, M. Talk. Talk. Revival flopped. I came back and I scared the crap out of them. Yeah, ain't nobody say nothing after Kamikaze. You notice. But when Revival came out, everybody had, you know, this, that, the third to say. He said, I'm gonna be around. Nobody ain't say nothing about 2 Chainz. Yo, what else he said? They should have said that to Tech N9ne or Jigga. Jay-Z is how old, and we still look for albums from him. So why they feel like Eminem should walk away? If you ask me, in his prime. If you don't think it is prime, if you don't think he in his prime, go listen to Godzilla and then shut up.
For Rolling Stone stars, I get 2.5 out of 5, and I laugh out loud because that's what they gave bad back in the day, which actually made me not feel as bad now. Because if it happened to James, it can happen to Shady. They do the same shit to Brady. More people hate me than love me. This game will make you go crazy. About to go for B-R-O-K. I was the.
That's crazy. He said Brady, the same reference that I made, he said in the song, bro. That's crazy. But that's what it reminds me of, man, because I was just watching something on that the other day, and it was like Brady still holds resentment from being, you know what I'm saying, taken so late in the draft, and that just puts me in the mind frame of M, bro. That's dope, man. We thinking alike now.
Brady, more people hate me than love me. This game will make you go crazy. About to go for B-R-O-K. I was the G, the O-A-T. Once I was played in rotation at every radio station. They said I'm lyrically amazing, but I have nothing to say. But then when I put out Revival and I had something to say, they said that they hated the Awake Me. I lose the rage, I'm too tame. I get it back, they say I'm too angry. I need to give me some drapies. No, I should hook up with Takey. Fans keep on pulling me one way. Haters pull me in another. Got more hooks in me than Swaley. About to pick up some weights and lift to my tattoo with Haley.
First they love you, then they hate you, then they love you again. What will it take for the win? First they love you, then they hate you, then they love you again. He just told you. First y'all started off, y'all love me, I'm lyrically amazing. Then these albums come out, and then it's, oh, y'all drag my name through the mud. I get it now. I get it. It ain't me, it's you. It's you. I'm still the same M is basically what he's saying. Still lyrically incredible. Still super talented, super dope. It's you then. And he said, that ain't no shot at Jay-Z, 2 Chainz, or Tech N9ne either, because I know how y'all are twisting words. Like, he's prepared. He's done thought this out. I know what they're going to say about here. I'm hitting y'all before anything can get said. Cause I know, I done figured y'all out. I done discovered the Matrix. Answers to the Matrix.
Instead of us being credited for longevity and being able to keep it up for this long at this level, we get told we'll never be what we were, bitch. If I was this half as good as I was, I'm still twice as good as you'll ever be. Only way that you're ahead of me is alphabetically. Cause if you diss me, I'm coming after you like the letter V. Killing everything, play this tune.
I'm so glad the lyrics is on the screen right now. The only way that you're ahead of me is alphabetically, because if you diss me, I'm coming after you like the letter V. Bring that back.
Diss me, I'm coming after you like the letter V. Killing everything, play this tune, it's your eulogy. It's your funeral, prepare to die. This is music for you to be murdered by.
Yo, he's not playing. Stop playing, put some respect on his name. Bro, and clear your schedules. We got, in the words of Loaded Lux, we got all night. We got all night. Till the next reaction, man. I'm out. Peace. Y'all stay solid. Hey.